We're gonna go through channel 7. This is how, this is like the grandpa to the Analog Archive series. And we're starting off with Alpha Alert.
Alpha Alert.
Warning, there's a severe alpha in the room.
Probably be
all
worse.
Beta males, run. Women, hide your children.
Tonight's forecast women... provided by the USBA. Oh, fuck. Oh, anyways, it's 67 degrees and clear.
This is like...
I love that it happens, 67 degrees.
This is like 2000s. I love the feel. It takes me back.
Oh, wait, what the fuck now?
Issued by the government.
The following message has been broadcast at the request of the United States of America. The Central Intelligence Agency has issued a level 1 alpha alert for your area. Please remain calm and seek shelter immediately.
Well, that fucking happened.
Now on to sports.
And now the weather.
I'm Tina Titties, and today's weather is going to be bright and sunny and clear with a small chance of rain and low pressure.
Thank you, Tina. Back to the weather.
Thank you, Donald.
Okay, now to security broadcast.
These are these like really short, shorter than the other ones? Because these feel like chunky.
All together, he ended up compiling them in one video. It ran for an hour.
It looks
and
so
8
fake.
Minutes.
I'm sorry, I can't hear what you just said. There's a fly.
Fazbear.
Ah!
I love the picnic table. What the fuck am I supposed to be looking at?
There's a creepy thing going over there.
Ooh.
It's a man.
A man?
Eh, what time is it? I gotta record a react.
Ah, fuck, we can't see his face. For all we know, this could be... who knows?
I don't wanna get doxxed.
TV head!
Yeah, but fucking...
Is that How To Basic?
That's maybe it. We finally found the person who is How
To
Basic!
No, these are fucking nudes! They're haunting the television screen!
He's standing over there on the top right, and he's like
slightly
invisible.
Did you guys hear that? Fucking honking outside here, man. UFO. Ooh.
We're sorry for somehow broadcasting someone's private fucking home security camera system. Yeah, sorry about that.
Oopsie.
Coming up next, telephone service.
These aren't too bad. They're just not as polished as... we're used to.
Well, yeah, that's because this is when he was starting out. All right, time for our telephone service. Let's call.
Putting me on hold. Fucking putting me on hold at McDonald's.
I have an emergency. There's a figure outside my window.
We're instead picking up a call. We intercepted a call by accident. Whoops.
Staring at me for the past like 45 minutes.
Was that even possible back then?
To intercept calls?
Really?
Yes.
Really? I did not know that. Were they the same like radio waves?
No, they just tap into the phone lines. You know,
oh.
It's just staring at me. Hello? Hello?
Oops. End of transmission.
Line 1-1, I just posted cringe. What do I do?
Don't worry. We're just gonna resume regular broadcasting. Oh, shit.
Incoming signal.
We hijacked.
Oh no, it's Satan. And it's morning.
Yeah, this feels like a high school production. No offense. Like, I'm not trying to be rude. Is it just me? Like,
I feel like this was real. They cut the, like, an episode of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air after that.
Yeah.
Like, halfway through the episode.
Well, this is a story all about how my life got flipped upside down. Oh, there's the ceiling!
Because it never cuts back to, oh, here's the programming. It's always like, ah, cut to a show! Cut to a show!
We now resume regular programming, already in progress.
Yeah, exactly.
I wish... I wish in this case, like, I feel like you could do more with it and actually add real TV shows in between. I know the whole copyright system, but, like...
Well, you could film some fake ones, like, one fake episode and then just cut in between chunks.
Which
it could even be a kid's show or something. Make it even creepier, like some puppet show.
Really cute. God, the Sealy Super Show!
So,
I gotta write that down. Never mind.
Okay, coming up next, Text Signal.
Ooh, this one looks retro.
A lot of them are.
I just like the vaporwave grid pattern.
That's actual music from the Weather Channel.
Yeah, Weather Channel has a lot of classic jazzy music.
I make my old people watch the retro Weather Channel on Twitch because they all fall asleep to it and they love me for that.
So soothing.
And then they're out and they're like...
And it's like, so boring.
They like one of the old ladies. She'll just sit there.
Remix.
Ricky, this is where your three boxes down. Hey, this is Reaction Gang. We're gonna have fun and we're gonna play. So sit down, all you kids, and people.
Huh? That way, without a problem. Programming, local forecast, and the late night news.
He had some fake commercials in the newer ones, didn't he?
Later on.
Yeah. See, that adds to the kind of TV vibes, in my opinion.
Shit, what's going on?
Hi, Slender Man! I feel like he tried too hard.
Yeah, it wouldn't say unknown frequency. It should just go static and cut to this. Because it's kind of implied that this isn't supposed to be part of
it. I mean, it does kind of give spooky chills, but I don't like the red. Like, I wish it would be more of a darker crimson.
I just wish there was no, like, this... Like, it should just be breathing and just awkward footage of this.
Or if anything, like, really, bad, VHS sounds.
But just check out Marble Hornets. They did pacing pretty well. It'd be like long moments of just creepy vibes, and then finally they hit you.
Well, yeah, I mean.
Gotta build that suspense.
I imagine that he learned as things progressed on. I mean, that's why he managed to get Analog Archives going. And he's also now having Eventide Media Center going as well.
I know we dunked on a bit. My favorite one's the N64.
Emergency!
Well, I'll be moved in by the 1st, so we can still make Halloween content. It might just be the week afterwards or so. Or the week... I have to be in the week before, so I'm probably moving not this week, but probably next week. We're going to find out when. I thought it was going to be that week. But...
Wait, I'm going to have to remove the fact that you were talking about moving.
I'll announce that on my channel. Yeah, it's a secret surprise, guys.
Or when it's pushed out, he'll be like late. Sorry guys, we recorded our Halloween shit in September.
A lot of people do that though.
Yeah, get it out of the way. Unidentified figure in Bucks County now.
Ooh.
There is no civil danger. The previous message has been declared a hoax. There's no war in Ba Sing Se. Channel 7 has... I kind of wish Sharpwing was here, so he would also analyze this as well.
See, this is a bit creepier. There's nothing going on. I kind of like that.
And not only that, what does he get through a TV screen? We don't know if there's going to... The only way we will know of what's going on outside is...
Cannot look at his face.
If it cuts to it.
See, this is what analog horror should be like. Shitty...
It says don't look aside. Now it says look outside.
Now it's like two people are, like, clashing over the signal. Because it's just like... It's just like Local 58 in a sense. There's two people or two groups that are battling over the airwaves. And they're trying to push out one view or something. And we're trying to figure out who's the good guy, who's the bad guy. And now the final broadcast, which is mark of the first actual season. It was split into three, but there was no playlist, so I'm just going by half. This was supposed to be the final broadcast, but Adrian continued on.
So you retconned the ending.
Well, so actually, he retconned the whole series when it went into short 21.
That's not a bad thing. If you're like, I could do this better, you just fucking say, nah, that didn't happen, and go for it.
Yeah, pretty much just, he said, this series is no longer canon to my story. And just, yeah. So now there's a civil, something's going on.
Don't mind me, I'm just taking notes.
Ah, are we going to be issuing the contingency plan from Local 58?
That was probably my favorite.
Go outside, on the lawn, face up, feet together.
Put the muzzle to the roof of your mouth.
And boom. What up?
We're sorry. Your call got interfaced by...
Interfaced.
I'm tired.
I want a girl to interface with me.
Interface you! Oh, shit. I'm sorry, everybody who's watching this. I work so much. These boys can vouch. I don't sleep. I'm, like, either sleeping or working.
No one's watching this.
Thanks for the confidence there, dude.
Alright, well, no, there's a group of people to watch. I'm just fucking joking.
No, but these boys can vouch. I work a lot more than relax. Good night.
Good night.
We will now end our broadcast.
Goodbye.
I like how it hangs.
Well, it looks like I'm gonna have to put an epilepsy warning on this.
That was actually pretty lit.
That sounded kind of sexual, though. What the fuck?
It was porno core. I breathe. Illuminati. Aw. I didn't see the credits so soon.
And now for the public notice.
Public notice.
Welcome to Channel 7.
What's up, bitch?
See what you got. So, recently, they received numerous complaints from viewers involving these hijacks, caused by radio interference from a nearby government facility. Those images were confirmed to be artificially generated by static noise. I am not Englishing. We're sorry for any discomfort. The FCC has declared that there is no immediate danger caused by these signals. Department of Defense has declared that there are no civil danger alerts in effect. I have a feeling that there's somebody lying. It's not kind of expecting. Ah, Made possible by viewers like you.
Thank you.
Please give us money.
Thank you.
End of broadcast, but I don't think we are. Man, I can't get the picture fucking right. Oh, fuck. Honey! Did you order the Illuminati channel?
Yes, honey, I did!
Why?
I thought it'd be educational for the children! I want you to open my mind!
You're making them want to not born!
I don't want to born!
Oh, Timmy's gonna be just fine! He'll be enlightened! He'll be closer to the higher spirits.
Timmy is gonna have nightmares for the rest of his fucking life!
No, he won't! I bake cookies!
I was expecting a scream. Cookies!
Okay. This next one, we're going way back.
Back
to the special
past.
Report.
We're gonna take you back to the past.
To play a special report, and it sucked ass. Say, boys!
Welcome to the Gonzo News Hour.
Featuring
Mindless Gonzo. That's right. That's the same song, bro.
So, boys, who wants to give Hitler a knuckle sandwich?
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Who's farting?
Sounds like someone's blown raspberries.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Oh.
On tonight's special report, word has come in from Arizona regarding the new findings in the Arizona desert. On last night's broadcast, we stated that extraterrestrial life had been found in Arizona thanks to the discovery of a crashed alien spacecraft. Today, officials have released a follow-up statement.
I love how he's shittily overdubbing this. This makes it even more fucking charming. Last evening,
the craft was identified as an advanced Russian probe built to spy on American soil. It was shot down by the United States anti-aircraft defense on the night of July 19th. No further statements have been released.
Okay, that's a nice take on that. I never seen an analog horror series that go back.
It is an interesting take.
But a lot of them just deal with aliens, or like, mostly aliens, I believe. Well, they don't really deal with, like, other things.
Oh boy, now we have our version of contingency plan.
Classified. 3, 2, 1.
Why did it have a shorter leader than the actual report?
Okay, boys, we're gonna go land. Let's go. Meow.
Hello, meow. Motherfucker.
Hey, Lamau. Is that what you humans say? Hey, Lamau.
Oh, fuck. I'm dying. This is cancer.
They saw something we weren't meant to see.
I feel weird, especially with all the shit that's come out recently about aliens.
They're gonna get offended at this.
I'm triggered.
How dare you misrepresent us?
I'm transhuman.
I am an alien. I don't confine to your Homo sapien. You xenophobes. You know what's really funny? I'm just gonna like stop for a second here and just think about like all the shit that's been happening in recent times. Especially with more people confirming that aliens do exist, and the government has been ignoring us even more and more, and people who were ex-Navy people or people who were in the governmental sphere where they confirmed about aliens and shit and more shit keeps coming out. I just find that interesting.
Now, a word from our sponsors.
Yoplait yogurt.
Ah, the Lockwood Pine Barrens video tour. Which makes an appearance again in fucking the Analog Archives videos.
Lockwood Hills Town Council presents the Lockwood Pine Barrens Tour. Have you ever wanted to explore
I know that music.
Beautiful scenery? Well, now you can.
The 90s commercial
the
music.
Beauty of the Pine Barrens. There's wildlife, lakes, trails, and more. It's fun for all ages, so bring your kids. There will be games and other activities at the main visitor center. Our tours are open 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., so come down when you get a chance. Thank you, and we hope to see you soon.
Ah, fuck. Who crammed peanut butter jelly into the fucking video?
It was me. I was hungry. Sorry.
Only one man gives me the raspberry.
Watch closely. Come closer, children, and watch closely.
Vlogging with Gonzo.
Hi, guys. This is my vlog. I'm out in the middle of the fucking woods. There's some trees. There's some more moss. There's a bark and... Holy fuck, what is that?
That's a bunch of dead
something
birds.
Something dead.
Hello?
Sorry, that's me.
We're starting to become that one short from VHS.
That was me, sorry.
God damn it.
It added suspense! Hello? Yes, I'm vlogging.
Just like that fucking one video in VHS, where the kids are going camping, but they were trying to record this entity that keeps fucking...
I love the pilot episode of Stranger Things. Sorry, as you were saying?
One of the VHS shorts, you know, the scary movie VHS?
It's a Hypnotoad?
It's Poliwhirl. A white thing.
But anyways, the title of it was supposed to be like a spin on Friday the 13th or something like that. There was this fucking group of friends and camping out, and there was this entity that just causes interference with the camera. They tried to document it, but it can't. Because it just causes interference with the camera. Even trying to kill it, but...
Beep. Ow, my ear!
Damn, that's definitely not me.
I know that's not you, it's the damn video trying to be interrupting satellite frequencies.
Who would do that? Obviously an alien and not a kid.
What the fuck was that, a VI bag? An IV bag? Sorry, not a VI.
No, it was a fucking water bottle on a stick.
Oh, so scary. I'm scared.
Nature's scary.
Guys, I love my nature doc. Do you guys like my nature documentary film? I did it for film class. Red! I'm scared of the color red!
Blood!
Death.
Well, I mean, in the Analog Archives, red is a significant color that kills.
Yeah, but I feel it's, like, too common. You know?
I mean, you can't be threatening with, like, pain.
Fox Slender Man!
Bit Crusher effect, hell yeah!
Love that earring.
Well.
Where are we going, guys? Why are we running?
That kind of went fucking crazy. I forgot about it. Sorry about that.
It literally is killing Ricky. Gonzo, this series literally giving Ricky cancer.
Well,
don't worry, it's not your fault. It's the Analog Archive's fault.
Analog Archives, it's cancer.
I forgot how loud this gets, and I had it at max volume, I think.
Yeah, same.
That was a major mistake. No, wait, I had it at half volume, and it was piercing. Jesus.
It's
loud
okay.
Means scary, kids.
Mm-hmm. Ear rape means scary, as well as
sudden
red.
Noises is scary. Jumping at you going boo is scary.
Boo.
Ah.
Boo. Oh, that was great.
Coming up next, Biohazard.
Oh, fuck yeah.
It's the 70s.
Good morning, Pennsylvania. Ready to die?
Yep. Yeah. Those red clouds look ominous.
Coming up, local news, the morning show, and your 7-day forecast at 45 any hour.
Nope. You know, that's rehashed stock footage that he's using. Yeah, I hate the fact that I'm breaking this down.
Well, I mean, a lot of the series that has been made so far uses public domain, you know, stock footage.
Mm.
Because copyright would have had this shit taken down.
No, well, here's the thing. What takes me out of the immersion is that, like, I edit so much. I do a lot of video editing, so I'm just kind of like, uh-huh, mm-hmm, oh, okay. So, like, I'm literally mentally picking this apart.
Of the United States government. This is not a drill.
Okay.
What, unlike that one fucking time and, like, what was it?
Hmm.
I'm gonna look it up real quick.
Scary symbol.
It's Chernobyl!
There we go. I'm trying to look it up. Is it going to be like an actually not a drill, unlike that one?
The Center for Disease and Controls prevents the issues of the following statements.
Coronavirus.
Yeah, coronavirus. It's unknown origin. To happen, it's extremely dangerous. It can result in seizures, hemorrhoids.
Hemorrhoids.
Yeah, that's what it says. The fact is going too fucking fast.
Anyways, 1971. There was an emergency broadcast system test that was supposed to be conducted that they ended up inserting the wrong tape and played out an emergency message that override a lot of radio stations and made everybody collectively crap their pants as if
Can we listen to that?
That'd actually
be scary.
Yeah, something that's actually fucking scary.
Oh, well, not really scary, it's just that it scared a lot of people, but it's just an incident. Oh fuck, this graphic.
Contain it.
Look like they're using the video of the testing of the atomic bomb on many, many fucking items. We've seen a couple of times.
This is really fast. Can't keep up.
Sorry about this, we fucked up again.
JK, bro.
It's just a prank, bro. Just a prank.
All right. riot and then storm warning. And then I'll show you the incident that happened in 1971. Welcome to the Channel 7. Right now, there's storms in the area. A severe storm warning is in effect for our area.
It's like a damn hurricane.
The severe storm warning is in effect for the Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and Delaware areas.
Gonzo, have you really ever thought about becoming, like, a news anchor?
No, not really.
You should. You'd be good. Or a meteorologist.
I debated about it, but I found out I'm not going to be able to make it.
Why not?
Stage fright.
Oh. Well, you do YouTube.
Yeah.
You do live streams.
Yeah, I think I have a hunch you got potential. Hello, I am Gonzo, the meteorologist.
We are committed to making the planet a better place.
My mother's sleeping, I gotta be quiet. They hear Viacor.
So that's why all of our energy solutions are environmentally friendly. There's nothing we would trade for our planet. Viacor.
I guess we got a solution. Oh, we got a commercial in between our severe storm warnings. Yeah, nice to
Samba, baby, yeah! Fuck you, I wanted a Samba, bitch.
I wanted these low prices and high quality clothing at MaxiMart.
Maxi, an armorage girl.
That's all I think it was Maxi's
world. The National Weather Service has issued a severe storm warning for your area. Please seek shelter immediately.
I am talking in my closet over my Xbox Live.
Believe it or not, a live broadcast of an alert can happen.
Oh, I know. What happened at my job recently, I want to say a month ago or so, we were watching TV and then all of a sudden they fucked up and turned on the emergency alarm system for like 10 seconds and then they turned it off. But I was like, analog horror time.
Wait, on the TV or?
Yep, on the TV. It happened live. And this is all satellite shit, mind you.
I mean.
Or digital, rather.
If it was a. Oh, shit. Well, looks like we're gonna have to evacuate.
Okay, everybody, get in the fucking car!
Just pull the book over your head and go in the hallway. You'll be fine.
No, you won't. Bitch, we're getting in the car.
Believe it or not, that fucking actually happened. It wasn't a drill. Like, seriously, back in high school, middle school. Yeah, in middle school, I was eating lunch, and we ended up having a storm that was threatening to drop a tornado at any given moment. In fact, a tornado was just outside our town. It lifted up. It made everybody go crazy. Basically, it started prompting alarms. And we basically had to evacuate from the cafeteria into the hallway without a book, though.
What the fuck? Poseidon! He has come!
And sadly, I remember that I was eating pizza,
Poseidon.
Fries, I had a cookie there, and milk. And it was just sitting there until I ended up getting it back, and I was like, well, fuck. Probably food's cold now.
Understand?
That was your concern.
Food.
Yeah,
my pharaoh's cold.
I mean, it was middle school.
I don't care if I die, as long as I die with a full stomach.
Well, in middle school, this kind of reality of you having a very fragile life did not hit me. And basically, I was like, "Well, shit."
Do you accept? Can you accept?
Catch that fucking thing.
Looks like Morse code or some binary shit.
Well, not binary, because binary requires.
Right, no, but I can't remember what the proper term is, but it's some kind of word code.
I know what you mean, though. It is some kind of code. But I may have to look it up.
The aliens are coming.
Why is it always fucking aliens with these things? Or a mythical monster?
It's like, the Slender Man. I wish it was like the Russian government or some bullshit.
That would have been much more
That's
believable.
The basis of, what was it? What not a red alert? What was the movie again? Fuck hell.
I don't fucking know.
I mean, actually in one movie, it was a terrorist organization that made a broadcast interruption happen. And it was ended up covering by like this one network. It's called Special Bulletin.
Tartarus.
Land of unknown colors.
The land of unknown shape. Did you what?
Do we know why he evacuated his place? It's because of it.
399? 399,
I believe, yep.
This isn't scary, this is just like weird shit.
There will be okay. More information. You are not alone. Beta tide shift in your favor. Yeah, this is strange shit on why Adrian just decided to abandon this shit.
I don't blame him.
But here is an actual incident that occurred that made everybody scared a bit.
Shit,
in 1971, the only two places that I ended up learning this about was from a Fort Wayne, Indiana radio station, WLWO, and a Minneapolis, St. Paul radio station, WCCO. I know WCCO is still active because they're a pretty prominent station within the Minneapolis area. I don't know much about WOWO after a bit, but this ended up happening. And I believe this recording came from, it came from WOWO.
25 before 10. Doesn't somebody want to be wanted? The Partridge Family.
Ooh!
Oh, fuck yeah.
We trimmed this down for copyright.
This station has interrupted its regular program at the request of the United States government to participate in the emergency broadcast system serving the Fort Wayne area. During this period, many radio stations will remain on the air, broadcasting news and official information for areas assigned to them. This station will remain on the air and will serve the Fort Wayne area. If you are not located in the Fort Wayne area, you should now tune your radio to other stations until you hear one which is broadcasting news and information for your area. You are listening to the emergency broadcast system serving the Fort Wayne area.
Studio awaiting further information. WOWO received this emergency announcement just moments ago.
This was not supposed to fucking happen.
We have to verify. We did verify the special message and code, and this is an emergency action. Directed by the emergency network and directed by the president. You've heard Bob Chase tell you that you are to tune to the emergency station in your area that is remaining on the air. WOWO will remain on the air here in the Fort Wayne area to broadcast any emergency information that is coming in. At this point, at the microphone, I know of nothing to cause this. We are waiting from Stuart Dan in the WOWO newsroom to bring us some information from any of our wire services.
Just imagine being in 1971.
We have been asked to broadcast this emergency information immediately.
It's like, oh my God, are we being under attack by the Ruskies?
Other emergency information the moment we receive
Who's invading
it.
Us? What's going
time,
on? Is there a nuclear bomb?
I would like to urge all members of the WOWO news staff in the area and listening to report to us immediately.
Sooner
we
or later,
do not
you're going to find out why.
The cause of this emergency notification, but we
Whoopsie.
Ask you to
yeah,
stay tuned.
But how it unveils, oh, it's going to be a
I'm checking
good
the wires.
Comedic moment.
I'll be with you the moment we have further information. We will cease all commercial messages at this time also. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we ask you, please, please do not call us to ask what is the matter. We are endeavoring to find out ourselves. We have received
WCCO
this
managed to get caught on
official
to
emergency
happened,
action
quick,
notification
W-O-W-O?
With the proper identification indicating a national emergency. We know nothing now. We are watching our wires. you probably will find that your own radio stations, unless they are so authorized, will be off the air. This includes the television stations. Now, please, if you are in your area and your radio station is still on, the chances are the emergency station for your area. WOWO is now broadcasting to its own immediate area, possibly with reduced power if you're getting our signal weaker. We are to be the information service for this area. This is Bob Sievers. I know of nothing yet. We received this emergency message about 10 minutes ago. We are continually watching our wire. I urge all WOWO newsmen to report to our station immediately to help us. And please do not call us to ask what is the matter. We do not know. We have received the official notification. We invite you to stay tuned to this station, WOWO, in Fort Wayne, Indiana, for information as it is received, we hope, momentarily. Yeah, now, this information is just in. Information is just in from the AP Wire. Attention news directors and all bureaus. Regarding the emergency broadcast message, which was sent by the Air Force on this wire about 9:30 this morning, Eastern Standard Time, and I am quoting direct, being completely honest, it says AT&T advises the AP that the Air Force at Cheyenne Mountain in Colorado put the wrong message on tape. Put the wrong taped message. The normal tape explains the message is merely a test. This is the one that we always receive at this time on Saturday morning. It says you will be further advised when additional information is available.
Somebody at the Air Force Base put the wrong tape in.
If you think this hasn't been something here at the studio, the Air Force evidently then at Cheyenne Mountain in Colorado put the wrong message tape on the wire.
Wow.
This concludes operations under the emergency broadcast system.
They thought the end of the world was coming.
All broadcast stations may now resume normal broadcast operations.
When it's sent out, people receive it and be like, okay, we got to do this.
Okay, so I'm just confused. Like, was the guy that was talking was the one that... That was the emergency... Not the emergency, but the Air Force broadcast?
No. This is the guy who was working at WOWO in Fort Wayne.
Okay. Is there any leaks or any recorded versions of that broadcast of the tape being put in? Unless this one's it.
This was basically it. This is just a chair check of what happened during that day in 1971.
They're not just low, they're ultra low. Hips have never looked hotter. How low can you go? The only thing lower is the price. You gotta get this look. Only at Old Navy.
Pigtails too weak to work it? Feel like you're tearing your hair out? Garnier Fructis, the first fortifying shampoo with active fruit concentrate from Garnier. It's proven. The Garnier Fructis system makes hair up to 5 times stronger and so much shinier. For hair that shines with all its strength, Garnier Fructis. Garnier.
We know you want to do more with your photos. Now you can on a Gateway Essential PC that includes a digital camera and the software you need to bring people closer together. All for $39 a month with an Intel Celeron processor. Call 1-800-GATEWAY.
Thank you.
All right.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
Now for Channel 7. Invasion.
Breakfast. Invasion of the Body Snatchers.
Hopefully, though, we don't have any loud noises, because one of the previous installments, it got very loud, and I had it out halfway.
As such as an editing file I am, this just... I love it. For those that don't know, I have a problem. I must edit everything and everything that I get inspired by.
It's 2:15 a.m. It's time to shut down the signal.
Community message.
Code magenta level event. In the event of recall, error message 70B will display it after reconnection with transfer. Oh, great. Audio. A national emergency event by the Department of Contingency.
This is a national emergency. This message has been broadcasted at the request of the United States Department of Contingency. Please listen to the following instructions to ensure your safety.
Did they get inspired
event.
By Local 58?
It would feel like it.
Because I don't know why.
A national emergency has been issued. The contents of this message will be crucial to your survival. Follow these and prepare for the upcoming event. Not much time! This has entered the United States airspace. There's an immediate civil threat. They are confirmed to be moving north. Those currently residing in South Carolina, North Carolina, Virginia, Maryland, Delaware, New Jersey, and Pennsylvania are required to blank. America cannot live without you. Your survival is crucial to the continued presence of the U.S. Follow these instructions exactly. Do not refrain. Let's see what they are. Seek shelter, lock all doors, close all windows, turn off lights, listen for any announcements from local authorities. If unable, look for the nearest available place to hide. Comb your eyes and ears and remain silent. Once you complete the previous instructions, remain silent. Do not move, do not look, do not listen. There's nothing to see, there's nothing there, remain silent. Just pretend whatever it is not there. You may understand. Oh Lord, there's spiders. You don't understand. Remember, there's something to forget. Oh Lord, this is gonna be.
Those
fucking...
are not spiders. Those are earthworms.
Oh. A sensation of curiosity or impending doom is common. The feeling will pass momentarily. It'll be over soon.
491.
Photo protection protocol will issue delta beam. Complete power outage will commence momentarily.
We do not exist.
Yeah.
Why is that the Pink Floyd album?
Dark Side of the exactly.
Moon. Dark Side of the Moon. What's on the dark side of the moon?
Ooh. Aliens.
Piggies.
Would you stop grabbing my boobie?
You want a piggy?
I don't want a piggy.
What happened?
Look at his fluff. Look at his white fluff.
Oh, he has fluff.
You want the fluff?
No. I want you.
Want the fluff.
Oh god, it's Siren Head. Here he comes.
I'm keeping my volume down just to be on the safe side.
Siren Head really is.
Yeah, we're reacting to something, dear.
Gunshot.
Accidental fucking blank?
Oh god, everybody's getting shot at, motherfucker.
Ah, the sounds of Detroit.
Oh, is that what the sounds is? I thought it was something clicking. I'm hoping it's not my fucking headset.
No, that was the actual audio, gunshots.
Sweet lord. So in Channel 7's universe, something was invading America.
It did have a brief change of logo. Instead of the Department of Contingency, it was, Research of Extraterrestrial Affairs, and based in Arizona or something?
I noticed that's a common theme with analog horror. It's always, like, impending doom, whether it be government or extraterrestrials.
Well, you have to think about it. There is nothing more harrowing in my mind than just telecommunications, fake telecommunication infrastructure. Because, like, you know, you've heard of number stations. You guys know all about number stations,
yes.
Right?
Yes, I wanted us to react to number stations. I find them so fucking fascinating.
Yeah, but how can you react to something that's pretty much been around? And not only that, not much we can do with.
I think they're so cool.
But I mean, we can talk about them still, but how can we react to audio only? Because most of it is through shortwave radio.
But the reason I bring it up is it's just like the thing of impending doom because of the theorized, oh, it's, you know, it's like a code. It's code for like nuclear details or whatnot, foreign agents. And same thing with the air raid sirens. You know, it's like it's just a droning sound that sweeps throughout an entire region. And you know whatever's coming. It could be nuclear, but it could be worse. Don't know. It's this vagueness that everybody understands at the same time. And it's just...
It would be really cool. I'm not saying it hasn't happened, but if there is, like, some real analog horror, that would be really cool to react to. Like, actual things that have happened.
The only instance of anything that would have resembled analog horror, like, say, just the basic broadcast intrusions is the Captain Midnight incident and the Max Headroom incident. And that's about it.
I thought there would be more, to be honest.
The only other broadcast intrusions is by freak accident. Like, at one point, somebody was watching football and the satellite feed got scrambled and ended up broadcasting porn. Which also happened to somebody who was watching a kids programming on Disney and ended up accidentally switching over to porn, the satellite feed.
I was about to say, it's like, yeah, with like real life analog horror, you're going to have to loosen your definitions of what it would be. There's that sort of stuff that Gonzo mentioned, but I'm also thinking about that incident where, what was it? It was like... coast to coast, some sort of supernatural radio program where, you know, this guy pretty famous in Hollywood or whatever the fuck his name was.
Oh yeah, I know about that. That's like the predecessor to Alex Jones's InfoWars. But
yeah,
I know what you're talking about.
He had a guest on where he was talking about he was trying to be like some sort of whistleblower, but like when he tried to follow up, the host tried to follow up with him or something, like he was just gone, like he never existed or something. I may be blurring a few details together, but there was something like that happened, and I feel like that's the sort of ballpark that we should be shooting for with in real life analog horror. If you were to find more of it, that's where it would probably reside, with just like, you know, people being silenced for apparently no legitimate reason and all this. It's just like, you don't know exactly what's going on, but it's still just this vague impending sense of something's not right here.
Yeah. All right. Why don't we continue? We got some breaking news on Channel 7 now.
Okay.
It's from 1990. I'm gonna turn my volume up a little bit.
Give me the music that they use, please.
I will have to look it up and see if there was. I know there's a soundtrack for the Analog Archives. I know we posted a soundtrack to the Analog Archives.
Yeah, but I really need their
Channel 7 special report.
Oh.
And I believe that's Adrian Chick.
CEO of Viacorp Energy Solutions, Mr. Cole Murray, has been killed at his house in Illinois this past evening. Investigators are currently searching for a possible suspect. Mr. Murray has been in the position of CEO for Viacorp for over 3 years, and his passing, says executive, has taken a large toll on the company. I'm sorry, we're gonna have
crap. someone intercepted their signal.
That'd be really cool if, like, they show, do more, like, I guess, people, like, more host-like kind of thing, kind of more of, like, the Max Headroom incident, if you will.
We are no longer in an analog world, we're in a more of a digital world.
I'm not shocked if this could still happen.
With the digital signal? Yeah.
Viacorp is always there for you. We are here to save the ear.
Oh boy.
Nothing left to fear in this world.
Ain't that the truth?
Our next evolution is upon us. Some random ass letters.
I think that was the Yiddish for something.
Probably Yiddish for nothing.
Ever free coochie.
Why did the news reporter look like fucking Nickel Sandman?
I was about to say, he looked like the smiling kid.
Broadcasted to the United States. Mission is to inform the American population we seek the truth. So the Hyperion is out there. What you're about to witness may shock you. You have been warned.
Oh boy.
So it seems like we're having something going on with this Viacorp.
Are they killing, like, anti-environmental people?
So somehow there's a little bit of a... I don't know. But there's something going on between... Ooh, fuck. Something going on with Viacorp. This Hyperion group. And it's all being on... And it's all being broadcasted. This little spat of trying to get the information out to the people via Channel 7.
Control, control, control. It's everywhere. Look around you.
Realize the power.
You're not liking the shepherd tone.
And the call sign. It's similar to that
blue. Oh, I love the Sheikah symbol.
The what?
Never mind, it's a Zelda reference.
Because to me, it looked like the same kind of bleeding eye that it was used later on in Analog Archives Amber Alert.
Okay,
when the neighborhood watch kind of started getting a little bloody.
No, this is the Sheikah symbol from The Legend of Zelda. They were the protectors of the Hyrule family, the royal Hyrule family, and then the Hyrule family backstabbed them, so that's why there's a tear in their symbol now, to remind them of the backstabbing. So, yeah, I'm shocked to see the Sheikah people are involved.
I got a theory on this.
All right.
Whenever a CEO dies of an energy company, I'm thinking, oh, shit. You hear, you know, wording like, oh, you know, it's like the time for peace has begun. It's the age of Aquarius or some fucking shit. And it's just like, oh, fuck. We're about to deal with, like, cults. We're about to deal with some big fucking cult, and I think it might be, like, eco-fascist in this particular instance. That's my sense.
Probably at then. And now, for the local forecast. A recovered message from 1999. A midnight broadcast. Channel News 7, WPVI TV2. And there's the BBC 1, or is it BBC 2 clock?
Gimme your soundtrack. I would like it.
Forecast and movie night and the county bulletin. How can the local forecast take up half an hour? Current conditions in Philadelphia. 70 degrees, clear. Humidity 80, pressure 29.9 inches. Visibility 9 miles an hour. Winds out of the southwest at 11 miles an hour. Looking at the forecast ahead, Wednesday will be clear at a top of 85. Thursday will be also clear at 91. It'll be quite cloudy through Friday and Saturday, and it looks like we have a broadcast intrusion again.
Damn it, I was gonna play poker on Tuesday, and I was trying to also go to the golfing ring that day. Why is there an intercepting in my TV feed? Oh, it's red, it's green, it's blue. Blue, yellow, I got you blue and yellow. Becky, let me smash.
Yeah, once again, the BBC 1 o'clock.
I will now intercept
abnormality, it screams. Transfer.
Transfer. Hello.
What else is it gonna say? Late era of the 14th sun.
Your moon will be in Cancer.
We'll be back soon. Transmitter disabled. Looks like there in the background it says that there has been a signal intrusion and they shut it down. So that way to protect the public. Gotta keep the public, you know, willfully ignorant, I guess. Oh shit, we got fucking NASA pictures up in this bitch.
Look at the Earth, it's so blue.
And what's this shit?
Crop circles. No, that's actually... That looks like, planet signal waves. Like, you know how sometimes people will get, like, messages through radio waves from space into Earth? Yeah.
Fire will erupt from your vices. And this all will fail like it did us. Shit, that was quick. Control your own people.
I'm sorry, the government is always against us.
Ascension, evolution will follow.
You will feel.
Do not open the box.
What's the box?
The other world is dangerous. You will drown in the colorless.
Listen here, motherfucker. I didn't ask to be drowned today. That was supposed to be next week's suicide mission.
Once you lose the will to speak.
I already lost the will to speak, especially because I haven't had my coffee.
In a playback. Follow protocol and the proper containment and security of this article. In case of security breach, physical reel is to be burned and destroyed. Interestingly, about an hour of footage has been cut from this reel. Almost as if they were anticipating this breach. Regardless, the contents of this reel seems to be some kind of moral code that they've been following. I'm not sure who or what broadcasted this message. It does seem to be linked with the department's recent behavior. I'll relay this to the other members.
They pulled that from Photoshop!
Okay. So
I'm sorry.
Oh man. I'm loving this already. So what we got the fucking issue of, what is it? Like a real case of what's sort of going on here seems to be, is it's actually happened before within the CIA with the issue of compartmentalization. I can't fucking pronounce words, but
okay.
Basically the concept that certain portions of agencies actually have full reign over what gets out to the rest of the agency, even if like a person has the, you know, top level clearance in the entire government, they wouldn't be able to get that information from that department. And so with this department of department of fucking contingency, I guess that's who we're following here, is there's some cult-like shit going on. And if you look up the FBI document, about a year ago, the FBI released a document about the Finders, which seems to be a group that sort of follows and strikes these sorts of chords of, okay, we let these guys, we gave them free rein to do whatever they wanted, and we can't pry information out of them. And if we did, because they were for decades just doing all this weird shit, we're afraid of letting this out because of our own fuck-ups. It's basically a giant omission. Okay, we fucked up big time. We created a cult. Oh, shit. Yeah, I'm loving this. Thank you so much. Holy shit, I needed this.
This is, like, really inspiring for myself. Because as an editing file, I just love it. Here's the problem that I, like, have with, like, this is that since I know what goes into making these things, it's so hard for me just to watch this instead of mentally deconstructing it.
You can see it in the fucking,
Well, you've seen me edit. I'm like...
through the program, and you see, like, each of the fucking layers to it.
Yeah, so I'm like, oh, that's what they did. Did they chroma key this? Oh, did they mask this? Oh, wow.
You know, that's interesting to see from that perspective, but if I were to think like that with the, you know, what I'm thinking about now, it kind of takes the magic away from it with me. A little bit of the magic away.
Yeah, well, because, like, here's the thing. I'm starting to work on my own analog core series, but I'm not going to say what it is. I'll tell you guys afterwards, because I need your input. Because
I'll just cut this out. Our next clip is a commercial for a haunted attraction. We got spooky shit on top of our Halloween spooky shit.
Ooh, spooky. Rainbow nightlight. That sounded dope. Gonzo, can you help me find their music pack, please?
Ah, current conditions. Partly cloudy at 42 degrees. It's 3:03 a.m.
Cloudy skies with a chance of shit.
Ah. Now showing a Lockwood Hills haunted attraction.
Spray for the kids. Ooh.
Farm's haunted attraction. This Halloween, experience
fear the demon of Lockwood
before.
Hills.
Take a trip.
Experience the fright of your life.
Beware the demon of Lockwood. Enter if you dare.
Look at their haunted hayride.
The fright of your life. Then come on down to the Lockwood.
And the flashing of texts.
Haunted attraction.
$6 per admission. Oh shit, they have small text and I can't speak. And I can't read it. You will speak. Festivities! Basking in the red, tasting the sweetness, drowning in the blood. The malevolent one, he's our savior, he is our lord. Ah. He beckons us to basking in the blood. Will you do that? Seek greater purpose. We seek salvation. Do you? Front end level intel breach. Oh boy.
I couldn't see the department symbol. I couldn't read it.
I know we missed it. I didn't even see the small text that was changing at the bottom of one of the slides.
Said that they weren't responsible for something.
You think I should, Oh, Paul. You think we should back up and take a look and see what it was?
Sure.
Not responsible for any injuries or death caused by this event. And then the text changes into something else.
Okay, now let's take a look at what it says. Any bloodshed caused by the blank. Oh, damn. There we go. The Institute of Theoretical Technology.
Broadcaster unidentified. Content.
Ooh.
Verdant level breach. I mean, you could just switch that in with the term Keter, and, you know, this whole thing would... it'd strike the same thing. Because, I'll be honest, I fucking love SCP videos. I love the approach to it.
Let's see what it actually says.
I'm putting money on Harvest of Blood.
Fall scheduling, paid programming, in broadcast. Oh no, let's Harvest the Blood, yep.
Harvest the blood of ye enemies.
Just gargling it.
Testing. Testing. We are testing.
Yeah,
do
shit,
not be afraid.
Help us! It's an emergency! The entire station is gone.
What?
The Channel 7 East Broadcasting site is shut down. Send help!
What does that say? I can't read it.
It was a Vernon thing.
Oh.
Wait, intel level breach.
Text in the back we can't even see.
Try to pause it and see if we could decode it.
Well, it was more just basic information, and, you know, that we can't really decrypt all that well. Just sort of like numbers, like, oh, this is this sort of breach, but it's like, well, shit, I ain't got the fucking key to figure out what that number exactly entails. You can make inferences, but that's about all.
We're going a little analog this time around. Idle routines.
So is this like the basic of analog? I'm confused because... that looks like C prompt.
The date is censored.
But looks like 1980 something.
This looks like 2001 or 2021.
That's Morse code for something, right?
Of course. Wire.
Fire Corp Wireless.
So, an energy and technology.
Now playing the broadcast tone. They can't even keep their tones consistent.
I love this diss track.
Damn it, we lost our connection. This
God damn it,
sucks.
I told you to get off the phone.
This channel fucking sucks.
Get off the phone. I need to use the internet.
God damn it, we have to reboot the goddamn system again. Who's in the control room watching porn?
Gonzo, you left your porn on again. This is why we're having issues with the internet. I told you to upgrade from dial-up! Is there, like, someone talking in the background?
I have the volume low, so I can't really hear.
No, turn it up! There's somebody talking! Go back, go back, go back!
Stop. Okay, you track us back.
Yeah, someone is talking.
There was some noises.
No, like someone was actually talking, but it's so faint, and it's like only for like a brief moment there, but I couldn't.
There's something wrong with the internal server.
No, it's...
damn, it's so faint that my tinnitus is not letting me pick up.
Okay, hold on.
I'm going to say the N-word.
Wait, shh.
Faint, but it's there.
This is a phone call between an engineer and a higher up.
So that's what's going on.
There's something wrong with the internal server. There's a crash.
So we're basically hearing the audio of a guy trying to relay this
problem. They're trying to look for the auxiliary power system or something like that.
You shouldn't have to look for those sorts of things, especially if you're like a broadcaster. It's like, of course you would have like a few uninterruptible that's fucking with my eyes there. Ah.
Oh Christ.
Uninterruptible power supplies there, so you know, you would find it, but you would say it's like, oh, it's like it's not working.
And now we get a distress signal. Adjust the volume. Oh. We found the signal. Yes. Come on. There we go. Hopefully it'll stay stable. Oh, God damn it!
Oh, let me try something.
No, oh, God, you broke it! God!
That's perfect timing.
Son of a...
Right, just wiggle this real quick. See if we can...
Ricky, don't touch it!
Hold on.
Don't touch it! No, what are you doing?
Oh, we got something!
No!
Don't do anything!
God damn, we got a number station over here.
Hey.
That's an SOS.
Yeah.
I don't know anything about Morse code.
The only one I do recognize is SOS, because that's normally what we normally hear if there's distress. Okay, we got
another signal.
I'm surprised
people still use Morse code. Oh!
Channel 7 broadcast is currently back on air due to maintenance testing. It will continue for 45 minutes. Sorry for the inconvenience.
God damn it, I was hoping to watch fucking Oprah.
At 3 in the morning?
You don't know about these reruns. Where's my Nick at Night, bitch?
It's not night if it's 3 a.m.
Oh boy, 3 a.m.
Turns on Nick at Night.
Okay,
mayday, mayday. This is Delta Romeo Foxtrot, the Deepwater Research Facility number 2. Does anybody
read? Who cares?
Repeat, mayday, mayday.
DRF.
Deepwater Research Facility. Does anybody read?
Whiskey
I know.
Tango Foxtrot?
Oh, that's NATO Alphabet. So he was saying, Delta. What was it?
Delta Romeo Foxtrot. DFR.
So, DFR.
Radio frequency. Somewhere.
It has to
underwater.
Be something.
7989 30. Repeat. 38.059.
Those are coordinates.
-70.79 8930.
Anybody care to write those down?
Rewind that tape and I'll do it.
I'll put it in editing and see where the coordinates do it.
God damn, you get like a weird island that nobody knows about.
I'm telling you, it's gonna be in the middle of the ocean. He says the water research.
Oh, now. Shit!
Oh, shit. God damn.
Well, something happened to that research facility. Somebody blew it the fuck up.
That's how the coronavirus was made.
No,
shit, it was an American bioweapon.
The thing.
Ah.
No. But yeah no, the NATO alphabet uses like Delta, Foxtrot, Echo.
Yeah.
And you would say things in a certain way.
It's called the phonetic alphabet. It's not just used by military, it's also used by air traffic control to, like, designate taxiways and shit.
It's also very useful for any radio communications, because sometimes, you know, it's like when they're trying to spell things out, it's like, did you say this letter or that letter? When you say Delta and you know it means D, you know, Romeo means R. It's phonetically, it's unmistakable.
Juliet means J.
Yeah.
Yes.
Very good, Kitty.
Whiskey.
Yeah.
No whiskey.
Cuck.
No, Cuck is not involved in this. Okay.
Charlotte.
Let's check out this employment offer.
Now, fucking finally, with the coronavirus, I need a new job.
Work Channel 7.
Let's see what the channel. Let's see, looking for a job. The Channel 7 self broadcasting site is offering full and part time employment.
Woo!
All right, let's apply.
Let's see. They'll offer a decent salary, need experience in communications and broadcasting, and unfortunately,
yeah, you'll get murdered.
What, Christ? All right.
Let's call that number.
Man, they need help.
Yeah, whoever the fuck is running this damn station doesn't know how to do jack shit.
Oh,
unplug
fuck.
Your guitar, you fucking ass.
It's Slender Man!
That's the Slender Man.
Fuck. I'm keeping the volume down in case it tries to do any sort of shit again.
Spooky symbol, I'm scared.
The Hyperion Uprising.
Illuminati.
Dear Ian, we know you're watching.
Hello, yes.
We've been watching you too. We've known what you've seen. Supposedly this is interconnected with one of the short films Adrian did. Called The Interloper. Are you looking for a job? We might know a place. You will learn the truth.
I secretly ate the last cookie in the cookie jar. That's what the truth was. Ian didn't put the milk back.
Scientia potentia est.
Pig Latin?
Probably.
Oh boy. Trees!
I'm keeping the volume low in case it tries to go with an ear rape.
Me too.
Because I don't think I need that shit again!
Giving me tinnitus.
I
have it naturally.
I've already had it because I was living near railroad tracks.
No, I've had it naturally since I was a kid. Oh.
Well, shit. How are we gonna fucking...
Okay, question. Was Channel 7... I remember hearing either you or somebody else say that Channel 7 was a better version of Analog Archives or something?
No, this is the predecessor. This is before Analog Archives.
Okay. Because, I mean, it's put okay together, but I feel like there is definitely some improvements that can be made.
Well, Adrian felt like this kind of went kind of all sorts of directions. This is why he decided to cut off Channel 7 at one point and just basically started anew with Analog Archives, which has some elements of Channel 7 in there. In Home and Surveillance, the guy who was watching it and became a big giant puddle of guts and blood, he was watching Channel 7.
Hmm.
All right. Now for a commercial. Made possible by viewers like you.
Thank you.
We'll be back after the break. Via Corp again, but this time through EcoHeeks.
The cutting edge agricultural development group that strives to make the world we live in a better place. Our research facility is located in Ohio,
Indiana, and Pennsylvania work day and night to develop new agricultural technologies that will vastly change the way we make produce. In addition, genetic modification efforts will allow for more quantities of food at a lower price. We hope that one day our technologies will help to lead our planet to a brighter future. EcoHelix, a Viacorp company.
Let me guess. Something's wrong with that company as well.
Oh, that's actually real weather music.
Oh. Currently it's 2:03 and the temperature is 64 degrees. Oh, and this is from 1987, apparently. Oh, a special announcement. Eagle Helix Noctis, looking for volunteers. If you're willing and able to volunteer, contact them for more info. Contact them for more info. Please.
We'll kill you.
Eco Helix will complete faster. We will all be one in the same. Our lives will be monotonous.
Do not refrain. Our future awaits. Oh, great. This is some fucking bullshit with DNA. Thank you for your participation. We hope to see the results soon. It's 2:17 a.m. We're sorry for that interruption. We have no idea what just happened. Let's just forget this fucking happened. I guess they're hiding something in there. They were right. There's little time now.
It's a different insignia. Maybe that's, Trying to fucking put it all together. It's like, fuck, man.
It's like hive mind mentality.
Who's ready for a midnight movie?
Me! Even though it's like 12 in the afternoon.
Jumanji.
Yes.
Channel 7 local television. Coming up at midnight is the midnight movie. And at 1:47 a.m., a town council meet and 2:38, senior perspective.
Get angry, you die.
The light, Rockwood. I'm keeping the volume low just to be on the safe side.
Slender Moon.
Lockwood has always been a blacksmithing town since its establishment back in 1835. But recently, some peculiar events surrounding a mansion on a hill has given Lockwood worldwide attention. Do you dare to uncover the truth of Lockwood Hills? Are you ready to dive into the light of Lockwood? Follow us on this journey full of mysteries, secrets, and the
natural. Looks like this is some other movie. Oh, fuck. Now we're getting interceptions. Someone has interfered and put random segments of film in this. And
that's
the Lockwood
old.
Hills monster, the kid in the orange parka.
Are you ready to look inside? Are you now ready to see the truth? Not many people have made it this far. Most succumb to him quickly. Now, look quick. There is little time. Look inside. What do you see?
Is it a giant beamy light? Oh, blood! Blood, 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 and death, and a killer! Blood, 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 dying!
Vernon level intel breach again.
Them damn
and
rascal
not only that,
kids.
That was the kid in the orange parka that would later appear. Oh, Public Concealment Agency of the United States of America. You're required by law to report an IA case to your local department. That orange parka kid later, there's also a short film about him as well. And he also is connected because he appeared in the analog archives.
He's an asshole!
Goddamn Camp Crystal Lake reject.
Time for our final segment. Good night.
Good night. Enjoy your sleeping experiment.
Hold on. Let's see what happens. This progress has been made possible by viewers like you. Thank you. Now offer more progress coming to your TV set soon. Athletics, evening news, paid programming. To the prisoners of planet Earth, your life is bound by shackles. You're nothing to them. You have free will. Show them your power. The truth is much darker than you think. Department of Contingency, we don't exist. Setito Terra. They control everything. The Order of the Tempest. Back as if nothing happened. Watch TV.
It said watch TV, bro. Like on our news hour.
Oh, I wonder why we're. Oh. Footage of the UFO.
Ooh. This is rude. I hate the fact that I edit so much. I'm deconstructing half of the shit in my mind.
Every time I hear that Gonzo News Hour song, I already know it's royalty free.
Ooh. Oh, fuck.
These are clips from some of the ones that Ricky ended up missing. The Eco Helix commercial.
Eco Helix will complete this.
A special presentation.
I bet that translates to something.
Probably. The civil danger alert. The employment offer.
Slendy.
The haunted manor attraction. This is giving a wrap-up of all the shit that we have to put up with Channel 7.
Listen, I didn't want to pay for this cable.
We didn't even pay shit.
What if our TV showed random logos and words that were scary?
Ooh.
Never actually any programming.
If that was the case, I'd pick the horror goddamn network.
think I was referring to Fox, but...
Oh. Well, that too.
Good night, Pennsylvania. Clearly we have problems.
Yeah. We have issues with our broadcasting network.
We keep getting hijacked, people kept complaining, so we're just gonna shut down.
You know, if you have the fucking Hallmark channel, you'll be good. All they do is play shitty movies.
Movies.
Don't leave.
They used to be super cool. Now it's like goddamn bullshit. The only thing I like on there is the Good Witch series. That's it.
Watch our programs. Don't go outside. Watch television. Damn. Stare at your screen. Nothing else. Unfortunately, they predicted 2020 in which we're forced to sit in front of a screen and watch a bunch of nothing. Something is actually outside.
There's a bunch of conspiracy nuts saying coronavirus is fake and they're distracting us from something else going on, making us stay at home.
There's also a conspiracy that coronavirus was man-made and it's not a natural...
People are so stupid. They don't trust anyone. Yet they'll read the internet and trust that.
Yeah, because it's instant information at your fingertips.
Well, instant information that validates whatever fucking strange-ass beliefs you have.
Yep.
So that was basically Channel 7. I mean, it went all over the fucking place, and sadly, it's the reason why, I guess.
Ooh, a bottle of fake blood.
I was about to say, it's like there was too much going on with the symbols and all that, where it was different symbols. There wasn't really anything, you know, keeping it all together.
Yeah, which is why this series just concluded. Analog Archives became a thing, and so did Eventide Media Center. Which there is... 2 or 3 videos? I believe 3 or 4 videos are made in Eventide Media Center, so we don't have very much to cover it with, but eventually when we get enough, we could...